Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's big news again. Only 30 minutes after I uploaded my last update, the dangerous volcano Katla sent us the largest earthquake swarm we have had in 7 years. So that night turned out to be a sleepless night for many volcano watchers here in Iceland and around the world. So the comment section on my channel started to shake as well. And I have to admit that for a while I thought we were about to see a major event live. There is a live webcam by the volcano and I'm leaving a link for you. And now, Saturday evening, this seems to be cooling down, but not over. So, what is going on? And first of all, experts believe that the earthquakes are due to geothermal activity. And mention in that context, unusually high electrical conductivity in the water in the river that flows from a glacier. And the gas has been detected there as well. So tourists have been advised to stay away from the river source and elsewhere where gas can accumulate, like in depressions in the landscape. So don't worry about me going there, for sure. And the river, it stinks big time. However, magma movements have not been ruled out, which is no surprise due to the increased seismic activity recently. But I'm a bit surprised how little attention this got in the media while the earthquakes were going on. Especially when it comes to news in English. Because the tourist season is peaking, the village week is literally stuffed with tourists, and a part of that town is within the flood risk area. And that is what we have been expecting today, or a flood from under the glacier that might be similar to the one that swept away the old bridge over the river in 2011. So this excavator was placed there yesterday and it will be used to dig a channel through the highway. It's highway number 1, the ring road. And this is of course done to let the water bypass the bridge and rescue it. But now, Saturday evening, there are still no signs of floods. So I kind of doubt that we are heading there. It should have started already. And it is obvious that experts don't know what is happening there. Lots of speculations going on, but no clear answers. Although we do need them. Because we have to bear in mind that floods from there can come down with such a force that they can create a tsunami when they hit the sea. So in case of an eruption, this whole area will be evacuated. But that is a part of a longer story, so I'm leaving a link to this excellent documentary I have online and talk more about my own concerns now, or how well prepared we are, since it takes obviously larger earthquakes than we had yesterday to put all systems on high alert, and I found it a bit worrying how little information was available while the earthquakes were going on. The National Broadcasting Service has a role to get information out there during natural disasters, and the only information that they could share that night was stories from scared tourists in Þórsmörk, that is just by the glacier, and they were reporting a whole lot of noise coming from the volcano. So I was wondering what does it take to put everything on standby, but what I do know is that there are exercises with rescue teams held at regular intervals in this area and it has been so for a long time. Warnings will be sent with SMS to everyone in the region and that is due to how serious event this will most likely be. And we can expect that the area that they will evacuate will be as large as the entire Reykjanes Peninsula where the last two eruptions in Iceland occurred. And when I pick up Katla Volcano from a map and place it on the Reykjanes Peninsula in the right proportions, it looks like this. And those of you who have been to Iceland, you understand this pretty well. Since this is the road between the International Airport and Reykjavík, and this is the size of the lava field on the Reykjanes Peninsula after the two eruptions. And when I'm using the Katla caldera only, it still looks a bit scary. But what I'm trying to do is to show you how enormous volcano this is. Like when we look at the eruption last year, it is a bit like a friendly campfire compared to what we are dealing with now. Katla is one of the major systems. And when it goes off, it's not just the fire and the melting ice that we need to be aware of, and it's the lightnings. So when we look at old tales, there are examples of casualties caused by lightning from an ash cloud from Katla up to 30 to 40 kilometers away from the volcano, or the distance from the Keflavík airport to Reykjavík. And this enormous volcano, it hasn't erupted for 100 years. And generally, 60 to 80 years have passed between eruptions there. So what to expect is unknown territory. And if we go way back to the year 939, the Katla system was responsible for the largest effusive eruption in recent history in the world. And that eruption did not take place under a glacier. We call it the Eldgjá eruption. And Eldgjá means a fire canyon. And the canyon that Katla added to the Icelandic landscape back then was 40 kilometers long and up to 600 meters wide. And that eruption left us with almost 19 cubic kilometers of lava, covering almost 800 square kilometers. So this is the Katla system. This is the brutal force. And this was not so long ago when we are into geology. This is nothing like the Reykjanes Peninsula, where experts can calculate the size of the magma intrusions and the location long before it comes up, so we can get the hot dogs ready for a campfire. So this could be the big one, the biggest eruption that my generation will see, but you don't know, nor do you know how explosive it will be. So what advice can I give tourists that won't backfire? It's a bit tricky question. And not even our finest experts can answer it. I would not hesitate to go to Vík, the village by the volcano, and have a good time there. But I would stay far away from the glacier and the rivers. And if Katla starts to behave like we expect her to do before the next eruption, or earthquake of the magnitude 5+, I would get out of town fast. And not wait for any instructions about that. And I have been getting myself ready to witness a Katla eruption. And my plan has been to plant myself around 30 to 50 kilometers to the east from the volcano, where it's safe. And I do have a 500 millimeter lens that helps me a bit. It will always provide me with some zoom, but it is no coincidence that I placed a super zoom camera on my wishlist for the channel recently. So if you want to support my work, I'm leaving a link to the tool that I need the most now, because I would like to do live streams and cover this as well as I can. My latest investment, the thermal drone, it won't do much for me there, I'm afraid. But the Reykjanes Peninsula is also telling me that I might need it very soon. If Katla decides to do something big, I will be there the same day, or as close as I am allowed to be. But there is more going on, and we got the news today from the Reykjanes Peninsula that almost 300 earthquakes have been detected since midnight by this old volcano called Vífilsfell. And Vífilsfell is a volcano that erupted under glacier at least 2 times. And quite interesting story that I'm linking to. We have been getting earthquakes there every now and then, so this location is not totally off. But it's quite a lot of earthquakes this time. So this swarm will most likely fade out and hopefully not trigger something else. And this video is one of the videos where I check the seismometers just minutes before I do the voiceover. Because things are a bit hectic now. And if something happens in the meantime while I do the editing, I will add that to the video description. So I am getting ready to throw my stuff in the car and do my reports from whatever volcano might be teasing us. Because, in fact, there are 7 volcanoes getting ready for eruption at this moment. This is very, very active period. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.